We appreciate you staying up late during this blizzard with us here on Valley News Live. We'll begin with that Valley Skycam view. And again, just roads through town even are very difficult to pass, particularly in neighborhoods where they've been doing a good job on the main thoroughfares, but they have not touched those in town too much. And because of that, a lot of folks getting stuck out there tonight. Here is a live look at what things look like down near the South Dakota border, though, as we take a look at our Dakota Magic Casino cam. Can we switch to that one, please? And essentially, well, we'll get to that in a minute here as we take a moment to look at the radar. Here's a look at the storm system that is continuing to move to the north and to the east, and it's centered right here near Minneapolis. And taking a look at the snow spreading from northeast South Dakota into the Duluth area and the Arrowhead, all these white lines are pressure change. That's what they represent, the lines of constant pressure. Where they're close together, the wind is the strongest. Where they're farther apart, weaker winds. And we continue to see brutally strong winds out there with gusts well over 50 miles per hour still in the Red River Valley, and an unofficial report of one near 60 miles per hour in Grand Forks here a little bit ago. Here is a look at that snow that's continuing here through southeast North Dakota and northeast South Dakota into central and northern Minnesota. This area here is the heaviest band of snow, and we still have some pretty good snow taking place in our neck of the woods. It's just starting to wind down a little bit slowly from north to south. Here are the changes to the warnings. This was just dropped. The blizzard warning just dropped up to the north in the Devil's Lake Basin to be replaced by a winter weather advisory in the Blue Counties here in the Devil's Lake area. Wind chill advisory off to the west of you. We have winter storm warnings continuing for much of Minnesota, and the blizzard warning continues for the Red River Valley, the I-94 and Highway 200 corridors of eastern North Dakota. There's that band of the heavier wet snow that continues there, but we have some dark blue colors here, a pretty strong layer of snow making its way down from the skies, but we're starting to see that drying push farther and farther to the south. It's a slow go. As we take you in, we see that it's right on the edge of Fargo now. So we may be wrapping up here with the additional snowfall in Fargo, but that's not the case in southeast North Dakota. It's going to continue there. It's going to continue in Lakes Country for the next few hours at least. As we take a look at your current conditions at Hector, it's 9 degrees. Feels like 15 below. Your wind gusting to 47 miles per hour here in the FM area. 3 in the Devil's Lake Basin. Still 21 in Wadita, but you are down about 5 degrees from what we were at 6 o'clock. Wind gusts of 52 this hour in Grand Forks, 36 in Valley City. Southern Valley seeing gusts upwards of 50 miles per hour as well. That wind continues to blow and visibilities are basically zero in open country. Here's your hour-by-hour forecast. The model doing a good job pinning the precise location of that cutoff line. And as we set this into motion, it continually slowly moves to the south. And by around 1 to 3 a.m., that snow field will start to erode. But look at this. The wind arrows say it's still going to be gusty. So they'll be blowing and they'll be drifting even into the first hours of the morning. Sub-zero temperatures north and east. Single digits for the vast majority, the rest of us, but just above zero. So we go through the mid-morning hours. Temperatures continue to fall for some areas. And it does look like we're going to be steady in those single digits, both above and below zero, for the better part of the day. But by the afternoon, the gusty winds start tapering off as well. So by that time, hopefully travel conditions will get better. But do not forget that survival kit in your vehicle, because overnight lows Friday night into Saturday morning will be ridiculously cold. Additional snow between now and morning. It's going down and down because there's less time of snow left, a trace to an inch for most. 1 to 3 for our far southern and southeastern counties. And then this blizzard is going to be all but done. Steady temperatures near zero as we go through the day in the FM area. And wow, a lot of trees holding up a lot of flaky weather. Rick capturing a cormorant area beauty. Thanks for uploading that. Now a look at your planning forecast. As we go into Saturday, the morning temperatures will be near 20 below. For some of us, even colder. 10 degrees your high on Saturday. We warm up on Sunday, but another shot of snow will bring an even colder air mass into the area. Andrea, I expect between 20 and 30 below. 20 and 30 below as we go into New Year's Eve. So some dangerous cold we'll have to wrangle with the next few days.
But you did say warm up.
Yes, we did say warm up as well. You always like to look at the bright side.
Well, you know, it's a couple days out, but
right.
It's there.
Yeah, there is one.
Yeah, thanks, Hutch.
You bet.